All right. Good evening, everybody. Welcome to Jazz Record Art Collective. Give it up. All around the world, clap your hands. Welcome to the Fulton Street Collective in Chicago, Illinois. Tonight we have the Andy Baker Sextet performing Wayne Shorter's 1967 record Schizophrenia, which is how we all feel right now. So with every show that we do here, we have a live visual artist, and our visual artist tonight is Micah Rademacher. Give it up for Micah Rademacher. He's in the lower right-hand corner of your screen. Speaking of your screen, that's how we're doing everything right now. If you notice, there's no doorman, no cover charge. So we're making the music accessible to everybody. We're not charging a cover charge online, obviously, or in person. So we're doing our donation tip jar right here. Right there. And I have a little implement I'm going to use. This is for the band. This is for the artist. If you would like to donate to Fulton Street Collective, you can do that as well. We're very versatile. Okay, let's give it up for the tip jar. All right. Thank you. Yeah, I've been working on that one. All right, so everybody's ready. The band is in the house, so we're going to start the show. Give a welcome to the stage. Playing the drums tonight is Dana Hall. At bass, Clark Sommers. On piano tonight is Reggie Thomas. On alto saxophone and flute, Greg Ward. On tenor and alto saxophone, Geof Bradfield. And on trombone, the band leader, Andy Baker.
Thank you. welcome to the six people in the room and hopefully a whole lot more out there. Thank you so much for joining us tonight at the Jazz Record Art Collective. Here with five musicians who I'm very flattered to share the stage with, heroes of mine and friends of mine. And this is a gig that we were supposed to do, I think, in May in person. And a whole bunch of people were busy and were going to be traveling and couldn't do it. And then the pandemic hit. And now nobody's traveling. And everybody can do it that I wanted to do it. And this is really great. So I'm very happy to have the band that we got here. The first tune, the first record from the album is Tom Thumb. And that's kind of become a jazz standard. Wayne Shorter has a lifelong love and affinity for fantasy and superheroes. And a lot of his titles reflect that. The next tune we're going to play is Go. Thank you. How about Geof Bradfield playing the role of Wayne Shorter? Quite a role to have to play. So this album, Schizophrenia, was recorded in 1967. It's an interesting, it's kind of a pivotal point or a shifting point in Wayne's life. By this point, he'd been in Miles' band for a couple of years, and that was a dream fulfilled for him. But at the same time, he was struggling in his personal life. I think it's fair to say, Wayne, if you're, you know, chime in on the comments if you're watching. He was still married to his first wife, but had already met his future second wife. And although the Miles thing was incredible, he was drinking a lot, maybe wasn't in the best place. And I think that kind of split personality comes through in the subject of this album and a lot of the tune names. It's also a really interesting bunch of people that he was working with, along with Wayne, was Curtis Fuller on trombone, who he played within the Jazz Messengers. Herbie Hancock was on piano, his lifelong best friend, and Ron Carter on bass from Miles' band too. But on drums was Joe Chambers, someone that he probably knew through Miles, but I don't know how much he worked with outside of that. And adding alto, maybe trying to kind of push away the association with Miles of trumpet, adding on alto James Spaulding. And finds himself in a pivotal point here as they move forward to everything that happened later in the 60s. So we're gonna play now the closing track of side A, and then we're gonna take just a few minutes to turn the record over and stuff. So this is Schizophrenia. And this is gonna have the flute on it, just so that Casey knows.
Thank you.
right, welcome back. We have side B of Schizophrenia. Welcome back to stage on drums is Dana Hall. On bass, Clark Sommers. Reggie Thomas on piano. Greg Ward on alto and flute. Jeff Bradfield on tenor saxophone and alto saxophone. And your leader for tonight on trombone, Andy Baker. We'll be right back.
Thank you so much, and welcome back to your computer. Thanks, guys. Welcome back to your own living room. So that first tune on side B is Kryptonite, and kind of unusually, isn't Wayne's tune, it's a James Spaulding tune. But I don't know if Wayne had a hand in naming it, or the name of it is what drew him to it. But Wayne, huge superhero fan, and in the spirit of tumultuousness in his life, maybe Kryptonite was something he was thinking about, because right around the same time, he was introduced to Buddhism by his good friend Herbie Hancock, who had started practicing a little before. And it took Wayne a little while to kind of get into Buddhism. I'm clearly no expert, but it took him many years to really commit to it. And part of that was him giving up drinking, which maybe there's an allusion to that in here too. Wayne, again, if you're out there, please go ahead and let us know. At this time, as I mentioned, his first marriage was starting to break down, and he had met his second wife. But the next tune on this record is titled after his daughter. He actually wrote two tunes for Miyako. The first was Infant Eyes, and he wrote this Miyako for her later on. So this is Miyako.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Miyako. One more time for you to repeatedly hit your space bar, please, for Greg Ward on the alto saxophone or flute, Jeff Bradfield on the tenor saxophone, Dana Hall, drums and cymbals, Clark Sommers at the bass, and Reggie Thomas at the piano. This is the first time Reggie and I have had the chance to play together, and I'm very, very happy that that happened. And I hope he's happy too. So we're going to conclude this evening's events with the final tune from this record, because that's the whole thing. We hope that you will donate, give, tip, etc., generously to the band, but also, very importantly, to the venue. Thanks so much to Chris Anderson for making all this happen and providing a venue for musicians to play and artists to paint. Please do support him and this very important place for us, as I think we're already concerned about which venues will be there when we get to do this in person again. And we're very grateful to Chris for everything he's doing, and he's quite a barman as well. That's awesome. And also please to our artist for this evening, who's absolutely killing it over there. So this last tune, Playground, was super challenging to transcribe because, like, the whole ether, the whole thing on this record is very, very loose and spontaneous, and that's what's great about it. But also that looseness and spontaneity and imperfection, imprecision that makes it so great makes it very difficult to transcribe. So this is the last tune. We hope you enjoy it. This is Playground.
Thank you.
All right, let's give it for Andy Baker, Andy Baker Sextet. That's Dana Hall on drums. Clark Sommers on bass. Reggie Thomas on piano. Greg Ward on alto saxophone and flute. Geof Bradfield on tenor saxophone, alto saxophone, and on trombone, the band leader, Andy Baker. All right, thank you so much for joining us tonight. We are back here, the Jazz Record Art Collective is back here next Wednesday, where Nick Kaplan Quintet will be performing from 1954. Clifford Brown and Max Roach, please join us for that. Is it Clifford Brown or Clifford Jordan? Clifford Brown. If you want to buy some artwork, you can do so. Please do so. On the lower right-hand side of your screen, you can see what Micah has done. The artwork is available. And if you notice, there's no doorman tonight, so we have the tip jar. Please be generous. There are venues that are going away for a long time, and we want to stay open. We want to keep bands alive, and we want to keep artists alive, and we want to stay up and running, so please be generous. On your way to your refrigerator tonight, or the television set, or whatever you're doing, please take that app out and donate to the band and to the artist. Thank you so much for joining us. We'll see you next week. Stay safe. Keep your mask on. Thank you.